Everybody, welcome back to Reality Show. So before we even get started today is July 15th. So all of the soaps that I have made in the past, I will put a little picture of them up right here, are available currently in the Etsy shop. I do have an extremely limited number of them, and I will not be doing another soap release until August 15th. So get them now while you can. Now today I'm going to be doing a Heart's Desire soap. I've made this in the past and I'm totally changing the name. I don't know why I named it that, but we're changing the name to something else. I haven't quite decided. I'm sure I will have by the time the video goes live, but it has three colors. It has a very pinky kind of purple color. It has a turquoise teal color, and then it has white in it. And sometimes I do a swirl. Sometimes I leave it a drop swirl. Depends on how I'm feeling. Depends on how the soap is acting. The fragrance oil I am using is Bite Me by Nature's Garden Candles. It is one of my favorites. It is a bestseller. Everyone seems to like it, and it smells a lot like fruit punch. So I'm gonna start off this video, of course, and as usual, by pouring the lye water solution down the stick blender into the oils that I have here. The recipe for this bottom batch is down in the description box below if you'd like to make it yourself. So I'm just gonna mix this up real quick until really light trace. Now that that's mixed up, I'm going to split off this batch into three different parts. They're not going to be perfectly equal, but we're going to try. And whenever you pour the color into the bowl first, you have to pour the liquid soap in very carefully so it doesn't pop up and fly all over the place. And I'm going to scrape out this really big container that I have here because I'm not going to be using it again, and there's still a lot of extra soap left in there. I get asked a lot where I got these big containers, and while I can't remember off the top of my head, I know that there are some really, really similar ones on Amazon. So to color this one, of course, I'm just adding in titanium dioxide. This titanium dioxide is from TKB. Okay, so now I'm just gonna mix up these three colors with my stick blender. Okay, so now that all of the colors have been incorporated, at least mostly, I am going to take my spatula here and run it along the sides of the bowls just to get any extra color that may be stuck to the bottom. Okay, so now I am going to mix in the fragrance oil, probably by hand, and we're going to start pouring this into the molds. Okay, so I decided to speed up that last process because I was talking to Caleb, and I'm not gonna lie, I just didn't want to stop our conversation. So my piping is kind of loosey-goosey because I'm trying to make this soap look super marshmallowy, and because I am doing a mica drizzle on top as well as putting two embeds on per bar, so I don't want it to get too hard too fast and not let any of my pretty things stick on top. So I'm putting three little dollops across, and of course I'm using the Royalty Soaps piping set that I created in collaboration with Nurture Soap. It's available on their website at nurturesoap.com. So in my personal opinion, and of course this is all this is an opinion, so you can take it with a grain of salt. So I think that BuzzFeed is probably the garbage can for journalism. I think that the people who write, quote, blog posts or, quote, pieces for that website are just doing a disservice to any sort of good writing that used to be available in things like magazines and newspapers. I think that you hardly have to be qualified as a writer of any sort, because the typos that I see in those articles, if we can even call them those, would just make a grammar Nazi like myself absolutely crazy. And the content, I'm pretty sure I could have come up with better when I was like a fifth grader. So there's that. I will say though that I do enjoy most of their quizzes. Like sometimes you just need to know what sort of a dessert you are based on your personality. You just need to know. I'm a donut, by the way. So those I think are fun. But anything that is written with like any sort of semi-serious overtone, it just, oh man, they just fail so miserably. And I'm not even talking about like I disagree with their political opinions or anything like that. I'm just talking about the writing itself is so bad that I just can't even take it, you guys. However, I will state again, that's just my opinion. I'm also a person who does not read any sort of modern day literature and will only pick up a book if the author is dead. So maybe I shouldn't be applied to for an opinion on such matters. So now I'm putting this gigantic dollop of soap on top of each of these bars, because on either side of it, we're going to put two pretty little hearts that I made with melt and pour and a mold that I got from Walmart at Valentine's Day. Okay, so now I'm gonna add in the little hearts on all the little bars here. So I have one in teal and I have one in hot pink. These are so cute, and I'm trying not to shove them in too much because I want it to be very obvious that they are indeed hearts and not just some like random shape. Man, pregnancy brain just kicked in real hard because Caleb is being a real sweetheart and is sweeping my floor for me, and I was like, oh, I brought in the broom in here so that I could do that. I didn't think you had to do that. And he said, you didn't bring the broom in here, I did. So apparently I didn't even bring the broom in here. This is not like the first time something like that has happened. Caleb, you should try to think of one of the other times where I've just like completely said the wrong thing. It didn't even happen. That might be for the betterment of our marriage that you don't keep track of all the things. Man, this soap cutting is going to have to be really, really precise. I am making extra sure that everything is in between the lines because this is a lot of embeds and it would be really, really easy to cut them up the wrong way. Well, there's one done, so I think I might go ahead and just do the other one, and then I'll film doing the mica drizzle because this is taking forever. Okay, so they are all in now, so I'm going to take some of my mica drizzle here. And I'm not going to put it sporadically. I am going to place it very purposefully on here. And I did make it pretty thick so that it would leave a really good line. Also, if you aren't following me on my personal Instagram and you want to know about baby stuff, because I know a lot of people have been asking me about that, I post a lot of stuff over there about the pregnancy, and then of course I post stuff on my personal YouTube page. And today is actually my baby shower, so there will definitely be some posts up. Okay, so the purple is on, so now let's add some teal. Ooh. I always think that the liquid teal looks so pretty. I'm gonna try to put some specifically up on these peaks here. Okay, so that being done, I think I'm gonna put a little bit of glitter on this, and then I'll show you guys a close-up. So this is what the soap looks like after all the glitter has been put on. It is a holographic glitter. So I'm gonna wait 24 to 48 hours to cut up these soaps, and then we'll come back to look at the inside. And we are back to cut this soap. So I know I am shooting from a very different angle here because my tripod is actually in my husband's car and he's at work right now. So we're going to try cutting it this way. Now I did have to turn the soap on the side instead of doing it face up because these little hearts got in the way. So I'm just gonna line this up then. Make sure everything's where it's supposed to be. And I'm gonna push down gently. I'll pull one here from the middle. And this is what the soap looks like, so you can see it's very, very swirly. The fragrance is super, super strong. This is one of the strongest fragrances I have. Ooh, look at this one. Here's what one of the end pieces looks like on the inside. So you can see, it kind of
looks like a hurricane in there, like ocean waves all zipping about. So all of the soaps that I have created since the green apple cupcakes will be available in the Etsy shop today. If this video is live, that means all the artisan soaps are available to purchase, and they do go really quick. So if you want to get your paws on any of them, I highly suggest you move now. So the question for today is, do you enjoy rainy days or super sunny days more? I personally enjoy rainy days because here in Texas, super sunny days means super hot days, and rainy days means we get a chance to cool off a little bit. Plus, thunderstorms put me to sleep. To answer, simply click the I in the upper right-hand corner of the screen to cast your vote. Thank you so much for watching. I hope you enjoyed this video. If you did, you can give it a big thumbs up, subscribe to my channel, maybe even leave me a comment down below, and I will see you next week because we are starting the 6 days of cupcakes countdown to my 23rd birthday. I hope you all have an absolutely royal week. And until then, bye for now!